Alright, here we go. Jump back in, guys. So when we left off, you guys are following the kid to the crash site.
You are.
So you see how much you could plunder.
Find out what was there.
And what's left. Alright. Alright, so you have a blackout communication right now with your pilot. The approaching sandstorm has kind of messed everything up.
Oh, that.
So you guys are traveling through the terrain of Jakku.
Okay. On feet.
On feet. As you're traveling, you're going into canyons, and he's taking you kind of up above, and you guys are seeing just a sandstorm coming blowing through, and it's really just disrupting everything. And Kolu over here is going to have to, you know, buff out all the dings and everything from the
sand.
Can't
see anything, can you?
Sand. Yeah, lots and lots of sand.
There's sand everywhere.
Picked a horrible day to wear contacts. Oh. Anybody got any saline?
Let me reach into this pouch.
Here. I got a utility belt to hold. Alright, so you guys follow him and he takes you some distance away. And then he leads you to a ridge. Okay, and on top of this ridge, he motions for you to come closer, but to crouch.
Star Destroyer.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so.
That's my bad feeling, is that that's what kind of ship it's going to be.
And as you do, you guys are able to see, for the first time, the ship that crashed. And he was right. It looks nothing like you've seen before. So what you do is you bring up this kind of computer model, mm-hmm. Mr. Hacker, and kind of put the pieces of the ship back together of what it would have looked like before it crashed.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and this is what it looks like. Go ahead and describe it for us, Kolu.
Ever seen Star Blazers? It looks like the Argo, kind of.
It's definitely a ship.
You are.
Looks like a cargo ship.
Solve that mystery.
Definitely military a military vessel.
Not a
not too different from, for those Gundam fans, white base. Very similar. Except lots of more missiles, so it kind of looks like, what if White Base had a child with Macross?
Or Battleship Yamato.
Or Battleship Yamato, yeah, that would be right. Lots of guns, elongated hull, has two sides, missiles on top.
Yin and Yang.
Guns everywhere, lots of lube. Anti-gravity, something or another.
That's actually
lots of engines. It's really, really cool.
It's actually six sides. Aft and four. Yin and yang. Top and bottom.
That's what it was in its glory.
And then mm-hmm. I get smacked off my yes. foot because...
Now it's in pieces.
Ticking off the Mandalorian.
And it's in major pieces. The piece that you see is the front part of it. You don't even see the back part of it anymore.
All right, well, if that's where the engine, or if that's where the command center was, I can hack it.
Yes, that would be where
let's
it
would go.
Be. That where it be.
All right. Let's go all see right. what this ship was hauling.
So, make a check real quick, Kolu.
Make a check?
Yeah, use wisdom.
One.
All right. Your scanners, you're trying to detect, see if anybody's out there still. But mm-hmm. the sandstorm is messing with your scanners pretty bad. So it's disrupting them.
Hmm.
So essentially you're going blind right now.
You've never done that before, have you?
Plenty of times.
All right, then I'm not worried.
I've never done that before.
I know you've got my back. Yes. Wait a minute, why are you in front of me?
So the kid, he tells you, he says, I'll wait here.
Right.
No, I don't trust him. He's come with us.
Let him stay. We don't want him getting shot. He can't be seen with us.
Okay, if he goes and brings somebody down on us, then...
He's not. He is... If he betrays us, Aaron True. Black is going to come out.
True.
You All don't right. want Aaron Black coming
I'll
out.
I'll trust him. For this moment.
You don't want the cybernetic... Hutt going after you.
You don't want Gracchus coming after you like a, you know, like a freaking dune worm on speed and acid.
He doesn't tiptoe through the tulips.
No, he stomps through the tulips.
Stomps all over them. All right, so I'm going to go hack.
And leaves a gross, grotesque slime on them.
All right, well, you guys approach the ship. Make another perception. Both of them. Even out.
Two.
I perceive sand.
Yes, you do. All right. So you guys move forward. As you do, you catch a glimpse of a patrol just in time. And you quickly duck behind a container. Okay. And as you do, you take a closer look and you notice that there's about two patrols right now.
Two patrols. Interesting.
Yes. These guys, what they look like are just your regular thugs. Now they got the goggles on and they got the headgear on and everything protecting against the sandstorm. But they're not. They don't look like bounty hunters.
How many?
They're... Four total. One patrol over here at the back of the ship. Well, the middle of it.
How many?
It's split in half just about.
So it's just four people?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the other ones are towards the front where the command center would be.
Are they walking away from each other or towards each other?
They're currently walking away from each other. Yeah, so two sets.
Straight.
Two sets of two.
Counting four headshots? How about you?
Yeah.
Okay, Go ahead and make it.
All right.
You gonna re-roll or add two?
Five.
All right. So you break out your rifle. You line up your shots, and one, two, three, four. You fire off.
Like I said, my man, four.
Six. Seven. Six and a half. It was two for the stand. You had to gauge. The first two were gauge shots.
Symmetry. I had to get both of them.
Right.
Yeah, and you hear. That's what you hear as they hit the ground.
Wait, that means they're not dead. I can go play with them.
Have fun.
All right. So, you know. More, you do know that these will be discovered pretty quickly. So, you guys need to move forward.
I'm going, heading for the ship.
The ship is badly, badly damaged. However, I'm going to make a... Using your fancy equipment.
Man, this sandstorm dumb.
Zilch. Gotcha. All right. Yeah, so you make your way through. The ship is just bad, bad shape. And you're unable to determine, if it just a crash made it worse. You're not sure.
Or
you have
it was
no
attacked.
Idea.
I want to hack it.
All right, he's heading towards the command center. What are you doing, Kolu?
Protect him. Better for us not to split apart, especially in this. We don't know where people are, where they're coming from. The way that my...
Well, except for the pilot.
Except, well, the pilot's fine.
Right.
I left the child...
Exhaust. Maybe cover up with sand, but that's fine.
Nice.
Pocket sand. Right.
He can just turn on the engines and blow the sand off the ship.
I'm going to throw pocket sand at him when I get there.
All right. So you guys make your way to the command center.
Yep.
I pick up sand and put it in my pocket.
All right. So make a wisdom.
Two.
All right. Verbal's quickly making his way. He is on a mission. I need to get to that command center. So he's rushing.
Mm-hmm.
And then you manage to pull him back just in time because he almost walked into a group of these thugs. Mm-hmm. They're patrolling.
How many of them?
So you pull him back kind of as you're about to walk into this room. You pull him around the corner. So now you guys are like, your back's up against the corner. You're kind of just peering over there. You see two of them there patrolling this little area.
Be very quiet. Oh, okay. Thank you. Thank you for saving my butt. It's Tupperware hunting season.
You hear them conversating between each other. Mm-hmm. And I said, man, have you ever seen a ship like this before? No, I haven't seen one like this. He says, but the cargo is nice. It's going to be a big payday for us. He says, yeah, it is.
Too bad I can't throw my voice, because then I can totally go, what was the cargo again?
All right, what do you do?
I'm going to shove them both with vibro blades.
Gotcha. Go ahead and make a roll. You got the same roll, didn't you?
No, that's... Yeah, same roll.
Same roll.
Two.
Two? All right.
We have the element of surprise.
All right, so you quickly move in, and you shank the first one.
Mm-hmm.
All right. He goes down quickly. You move on to the next one, and as you do, he catches you just in time, and then he manages to fire off a couple blasts before you get him, and you cut him down with the fireball blade. But he did fire off a few blasts, and now the attention has been gathered.
Well, frack. So, how quick can you hack this thing?
Let's go. All
right. Pull out my blaster. Set up post behind cover.
Gotcha. And then he moves, and Verbal moves into the next room, which is where the command console is.
Mm-hmm.
So, you're providing cover for him as he's hacking.
Yes.
All right. What you got?
Three, four. Because I'm under pressure, so I have plus three.
Yeah, about to ask.
So that's zero. One plus three is four.
All right. Gotcha. So you got a four. All right. And you successfully hack it. So you're into the system now. And what you're doing is you're basically downloading all the logs and everything for the ship. Manifest everything.
Yep.
But it's going to take some time.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So, Kolu. Yes. So, you're set up, and all of a sudden, you see him start coming in.
Brother, do your thing.
All right. You got two guys that come into the room. You're set up behind a container, and you fire off.
Five.
All right, yeah. You take off both of them with quickness. Two blaster shots. Damn.
They're coming, but I'm stopping them.
All right.
You look at the download. We're at 15%, guys.
Hey, more kills.
Feel like Captain Marvel.
Yeah.
What is this? pages.
All right. Another wave comes in. This time, three guys. Kill them.
Since I'm technically not hacking right now, I'm downloading. Can I give him two? Can I assist?
Yeah.
Okay, so add two.
It gives him one.
One, that's right. It changed in this game to one. That's
but
right.
Yeah, you're doing distraction. Just hey, look, you're just firing off a blaster somewhere in that direction.
I want to keep that safe. Don't want to use too much.
So it gives you a one.
So it gives me a one. It's going to be a two.
It's going to be a two?
Yes.
Do you want me to really piss you off, your character? Yeah. I'll say, do you want me to piss you off or encouragement? Where's Django when we need him?
Oh, no, I'm about to kill all of them.
And you turn around and you're like, don't ever say that again.
All right, so you manage to take one down, mm-hmm. But the other two flank, and when they do, they fire off blaster shots and it hits you for three shifts. To take a blaster shot to the shoulder.
Alright.
Just scuffed your armor.
Alright, swamp rats. You're going down.
So you guys are trading blaster shots back and forth. Go for it. The dice really hate you tonight.
Do you want to try one of these?
Yes.
You want to try these?
Sure, I'll try
all the dice.
Oh my god.
And the same result.
One. It's fine.
Alright, so you guys are trading blasts back and forth. A couple of them get close to you, and they hit right in front of you, and when they do, they just kind of like light up your visor. So just blind you temporarily, you know, for a split second,
mm-hmm.
And then you get back to blasting once again.
All right, you jerks. Two.
Plus one. Can I shoot? Can I help him every time or just the one time?
Oh, you can every time.
See there.
Oh, two, three.
She had three. Gotcha. All right. So you end up taking out two more.
These guys are really agitating me.
But at this
we're
point,
about 40% now.
Actually, you guys are about 60% right now.
Yeah. So probably one or two more.
Yeah, another wave just starts coming in.
Yep.
But this time, before they actually enter the room, you hear clink, clink, clink.
Kick it. We don't want that. Grenade!
Right. Grenade.
Here, grenade!
Can I kick it towards them?
Yeah, go ahead.
Gonna be a three.
Yes.
Three?
Plus one is four.
All right.
Plus four? Yeah, four.
Yeah, it bounces into the room, and so then you take it and you just kind of kick it back out there towards them, and it goes down one to the left side and explodes.
And you hear, aye!
So this huge explosion goes off, and it actually rips a hole into the hull of the ship.
Glad that wasn't me.
Right. Do we want this? No, we don't want that.
You hear, who is this guy?
Your worst nightmare.
I don't know. But he's not going to make it out of here alive.
I am your worst
nightmare.
They
fire off two shots at you. Go ahead. He has a trading fire again as they move into the room.
Dog.
Plus one.
One.
Which ones have you tried these yet?
So
I've not tried these yet.
Okay.
You guys trading blasts back and forth, and a few more blaster bolts hit you, doing two shifts of damage.
These guys are going to owe me so much money.
Gracchus will not hear the end of this one.
You're about 85% right now.
Five.
Did you have the one?
Yeah, it takes out the final two, yeah. So you fire two more shots and boom, you take the other two down. All right, and you guys have hit 100% on the download.
Let's get the heck out of here.
Yes, let's get out of here. Wait, hold on. Is there more cargo here?
I would be willing to bet not, but let me check the manifest really quick.
Would he be able to tell there was?
Well, the cargo would be held in the other part of the ship.
Yeah, I don't even know where that part is.
Yeah, you guys are in the forward part of it.
Well, that's what we're sent here to grab, right?
Well, let's go read these.
To locate it, yeah.
Let's go read these logs first and see what we see, and then we can come back and find the other part of the ship.
Yeah.
We're going to take Boy with us.
Yes. We need to go.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so you guys lead the ship, right? You go out with the holding you made with a grenade.
Yeah.
All right, as you do, you start going back towards the ridge, and then you see up ahead and you hear a scream. And you see, looks like this armor-clad fellow that has grabbed a boy.
Shoot him.
And he quickly grabs a boy, and then before you know it, he just disappears off the ridge.
Do you have a locator or a tracker right now?
I'm going to try and shoot a tracker at him.
No. Hmm? Put one on the ship. So we can come back.
Oh, yeah. I'll put a tracker on the ship so we can come back.
Okay. You quickly just shoot a tracker onto the ship. Mm-hmm. Mark its location.
Yeah.
Gotcha. I mean,
we can go find the boy, but if we put a tracker on the ship, we can come back if we don't catch up to the kid. Does that make sense?
Well, the kid is of no consequence to us because, remember, we're not affiliated with Gracchus.
That's true. All right.
But the kid also may know.
The kid would know, he would spill things out.
Where the other part of the ship was.
He might know where the other part of the ship is.
Frack.
Because I don't think it's on this ridge. I think it might be way far away. I think that the engines went that way and this part went that way.
That is true.
Let's go get him.
Okay.
Except that I need this fate, I would give it to you and say,
I agree. We have to go.
Yeah, how would I? Yeah.
Let's go get the youngins.
Oh, yeah, I'm asking about that part on you, the bounty hunter part.
Let's go.
You have a mission to accomplish, and you need that kid to do it.
We need him alive, well, after all.
To do it easy. You could do it the hard way.
No, we're going to do it easier. I don't like the hard way.
Now, as this happens, you notice behind you, two speeder bikes pull up, and they start firing at you.
Hey, we can kill them and then take the speeder bikes and chase after them. Let's go. Let's do this.
All right, so both of you make rolls. What are you doing?
I'm returning
taking
fire.
Taking cover, returning fire. What are we doing?
I'm going to throw myself behind a barrier.
Returning fire, five.
I'm going to flip myself onto the blaster bolt.
Five,
all right.
One.
Yeah, one.
One. I'm going to wait for him to come by and then try and grab him off the bike.
All right, so, Kolu, you line up a shot, you take him out. You know, you took the driver out, headshot, the speeder bike hits the ground, and then just stops right in front of you. Kind of slides a little bit to a stop.
And you're just like, sweet action, baby.
Verbo, on the other hand,
I got hit.
Mm-hmm. You got hit by debris from the blaster. One shift.
Uno.
Did you just singe my armor?
Yeah. My robe.
It's Imperial grade uniform.
Yeah.
And then, of course, that spear bike flew by and then turned around to come back around for another pass. What do you do?
Can you take him out, too?
Are you going to just assist him?
Yeah.
Okay, so he gives you a plus one.
Plus one, that's going to be a six.
Oh, yeah. You just took him out. Just wait for him to drive by and you just barber bladed him in the chest. Just, ah!
I swear, you'd think these guys were stormtroopers with their aim.
You take a closer look at them, and you realize these guys, they are their raiders, is what they are. Locals, you know, from this planet. Most likely hired by the bounty hunters for muscle.
Alright, this,
never send an idiot to do your work.
Yeah. Alright, so you have two speeder bikes now.
Let's go.
Alright, let's go chase this guy.
Up that ridge.
You can chase the guy, gotcha.
Yes. Is he on a speeder bike, or is he just on foot?
You notice they're on speeder bikes.
Alright, let's
When you get up there and you do a quick little investigation, you noticed that the footprints have ended, and all of a sudden you see just like a drag mark. Just one mark. And then you look off in the distance, you can see like a little small dot.
Let's chase after him. Let's shoot the speeder bike and shoot him.
Live to ride, ride to die.
Alright, so you guys jump on the speeder bikes and you take off. Alright. So go ahead and make an intelligence roll.
Oh, Lord.
Where have you been all my life?
Good job. That's a great job, Verbal. All right, Verbal, this is what you have noticed. You quickly get a layout of the region, of the ridge, and so you plot a course that will allow you guys to make up for lost time and catch right up to them.
Sweet.
Away.
That's what I said.
All you right, take a couple of shortcuts, you know, through the canyon, and like you go in through a cave,
right?
And you pop out, and as you pop out, you guys pop out right behind them. All right, so go ahead. You got three speeder bikes. You got the two behind, and you got the one that's in the front that's got the kid on the back.
I'll take out the leader. First and foremost.
Go for it.
It's going to be a three.
What is it? What am I rolling?
Dexterity.
Two.
Three.
Three?
Yes.
Yep. All right.
I took the one on the right. You said there was two and then the leader.
Yes, there's two and the leader. You took the one on the right. You took the one on the left, right, Kolu?
Mm.
All right, Kolu.
Well, I was trying to take out the leader.
The leader?
But I'll go ahead and take the one on the left. Makes more sense.
Okay. Gotcha. So yeah, you do. You fire off a couple blasts and you hit the speeder just right like you've done this before and it explodes in flames. Alright. Verbal, you hit the speeder and you end up nicking it to where he basically just kind of loses control. And the bike goes down and he flies off of it.
Aye! Yes.
Now you got the leader. He kind of looks behind him and he sees, you know, what's happened. Mm-hmm. So all of a sudden you see him do his arm and just kind of throw something behind him. Make rolls. It's not the kid he's throwing.
What
the? A little small object.
Six. I want to catch it and throw it back.
You got a two.
Well, he more than makes up for it.
Yeah. Look what I got. I've never rolled that ever.
It's not good. It's not bad.
It's not good.
That's
it's not bad.
Actually average.
Damn. All right. So, yeah, six.
Six. Yep. So, you do. You take it and you throw it back.
Bounce it off the back of his head.
It goes off, and when it goes off, it's an ion grenade, which just completely covers the speeder. It loses power, hits the ground hard, kid goes flying off of it, off the speeder. Would you like to make a save, Verbal? Meanwhile, the leader goes the other direction, and that's where Kolu is going.
I'm gonna make a pass at him.
Zero. The first one was negative one, this one's zero. If I'm still rolling dexterity.
I'm going to make a pass at him, and I'm going to shoot him with a speeder bike.
All right, go for it.
Or maybe two.
Two. All right. So you make a pass with a speeder bike, and you fire off the blast. We see him roll out of the way just in time, so the blast hit the dirt as you fly by him. Meanwhile, verbal, you were not able to catch the kid in time, so the kid kind of hits the ground hard. All right, and when he does, he rolls and then he smacks up against a rock. Kid's out cold.
Well, I'll go pick him up, put him on my bike.
All right.
When I make another pass at him, I'm gonna roll first. Hopefully, get to do what I have in my head. It's gonna be another two.
Two? All right. You make another pass at him, mm-hmm. but this time you see him. He throws what looks like little knives, and they hit the side of the speeder bike and just completely disable it. So your speeder bike hits the ground hard, throws you off of it, mm-hmm. and then the bike just kind of tumbles and smacks into a rock. You get back up and you see him. He looks directly at you, and you can tell that he's one of those the bounty hunters. He's got armor on, mm-hmm. and it looks like he's got like a mixture of like some steel plates. He's got some hide armor, mm-hmm. you know, and his mask. It looks very similar to the leader's, and the fact that it's like a skull, but it doesn't have the two horns coming out the side. Mm-hmm. He's got like two horns come up the top, short horns.
I hold my hand up. Read between the lines, son.
He pulls out a blade. Pulls out another one, and then he kind of twirls them in his hands.
I roll.
All right. Go for it.
That is so weird. All right. I'm going to make it a five. I'm going to pull out my blaster and shoot him.
Indiana Jones style.
Exactly.
Well, you succeeded with style, sir. So, you have... This is the aspect on him. We're just going to leave right there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, you get free invoke, but basically, you know, he starts charging towards you, and then you just quickly pull out your blaster and fire, and you hit him dead in the chest. As you do, he kind of gets staggered, and he kind of falls to the ground forward. He picks himself back up. He's got this blaster hole, in his armor. And he's kind of a little woozy right now. Lost his bearings. All right, you can capitalize on it.
I'm going to. Maybe. That's a plus two, right?
Yep, that's a plus two. It's just like your fate.
So it's going to be three. It's going to be a three. Now I'm just going to shoot him again.
All right, you shoot him again. You know, you hit him again, this time in the shoulder. All right, but he's still moving towards you.
All right.
What do you do now?
Well, I got a two. I want to pull out a vibroblade, like the actual sword.
Yeah.
Because I have one. I'm going to charge at him.
All right. Cool. And what was the total?
Two.
Two. All right. So you charge at him, and this is finally what he's been waiting for. Close combat.
What am I rolling if I roll to shoot the
dexterity.
Dex.
One. I was going to shoot him with the guns on the speeder bike because I don't have a weapon.
All right. So... You come down with a sword.
Mm-hmm.
All right. He quickly dodges out of the way, and then he comes in, goes across to your abdomen with the blade, dealing a shift. Meanwhile,
man, what's up with these people messing verbal, up my armor, man?
He comes in, he fires off a few blasts, all right, which causes a distraction, so he gives you a boost.
All right.
Which boost works just like aspects that for one-time use.
Okay.
All right. So he fires and it hits the ground and blows up, you know, sand and dirt in between the both of you. And so you capitalize on it. Or at least try to.
It's Yeah. Wait, the aspect is always there, or?
Well, the aspect, you get one free invoke. Other than that, you have to spend a fate to invoke it. But the boost you can use for free. It's a one-time use, though. It's a reroll or to plus two.
I'll reroll that.
All right, you can use the distraction?
Yeah.
All right, you're utilizing the distraction. You're moving in.
That's better. Four.
Under the cover of the sand and debris. All right, you go in and you strike them. You barely make contact with him, but it does make contact. You can tell because he had a little blood on your blade. All right, so he grabs his side. He backs off a little bit. And he says, "You are well trained, Mandalorian."
Quit your talking. And face me, son.
That's better. Three.
Three. All right.
Shoot him in the back because his back is to me.
All right. I'm going after his neck. Four.
Four. All right. Well, the speeder bike comes in again. He blasts and he creates another distraction. You know, it actually covers both of you with sand this time.
Sorry.
As your blades match each other. So you've got your sword coming down, and he has two knives that are up against, crossed against a blade. So now you guys are pushing against each other.
Okay.
All right. You have a free boost there. That you're probably going to use right now, because you just rolled negatives. You can roll again and try to give him another attack or something.
It's going to be a five.
Five, all right. And what are you doing this time? You going for the neck still?
Yep.
Still bringing it down?
Yep.
All right. So you use your advantage. You have that power over him, and you bring the blade closer to him and closer, and then you end up breaking his blades. As you apply so much pressure against him. And then the blade, your blade, goes against his neck. Clean.
Say hi to Django for me.
It's a good thing because my gun's jammed.
Don't ever say you need help from Django. You see that? That what happens to Django.
So yes, you decapitated him.
All right, let's see what, I definitely don't want his armor.
Verbal brings the speeder back over, and he knows that the kid is unconscious because he's bleeding from his head.
But he's still alive.
He's still alive.
Let's get him back to his hut. Right, let's go back there, make sure that he heals up just fine. We don't want him to be beaten.
Right.
Yep.
And thus, this is how I do stealth. I kill everybody in. Exactly. Alright, so let's get back to the gunship and figure out where this other part.
All right, you guys get back to the gunship. All right, and you lay him down, and you use his medical supplies he has, the last that he has of them actually, to kind of stabilize his condition. Meanwhile, verbal, you're going through the records.
Yep. All
right. And as you do, you get the information on the ship, you know where what it is and everything. You pull up the records of the last transmissions before it went down. All right. And you hear a mayday. It's the captain. It says, "This is the captain. Captain John Doom of the of the USS Latveria."
Okay.
It says, "Yeah, our ship. It's under attack. We've lost all functions. We are crashing. This is a mayday. We've released all escape pods. If there's anybody out there, please help.
What's attacking them though?
And you just hear just
nobody help them. What attack them though? That's what I need to go back. Rewind.
So you go back a little bit further into the records, and you realize that this ship, according to the star charts, so to speak,
mm-hmm.
All right, it utilizes charts you've never seen before. Not in this galaxy, at least. It somehow traveled from there to here.
Hmm.
And then shortly after arriving in this system, it basically had a crash course with Jakku.
So before I research that,
look at the date. When did this happen? Okay. That's right. You just said it happened 2 days ago.
Mm-hmm.
Should we look for this John Doom?
I want to see what the cargo was first.
Yeah, you go through the manifest list and such. All right, and you find that this ship actually had the supplies, medical. It was full on medical. They had weapons. They actually, their weapons, you find the plans, and they are actually able to weaponize the kyber crystals.
We need to find these.
And apparently the most of their cargo was kyber crystals. However, some of them would cause some damage to the ship when they were exposed to high amounts of energy.
Right.
Most likely from whatever was attacking them. And then it ended up causing a chain reaction in parts of the ship.
Okay.
Which would explain how it,
Was there anything called spice on this ship?
Yes. There was.
I'll show you why I asked that question. So my other contact, while we were under attack, asked me that.
Huh.
So I'm going to go through this manifest or through the logs. Are they from anywhere near a planet called Ryloth?
The ship?
Yeah.
No. When it entered this galaxy, so to speak, when it appeared near Jakku.
And well, I know, but I'm looking to see where it came from.
Oh, that's where I'm showing you, is that it came from a different star chart that's not part of this galaxy.
Oh, I don't know if Ryloth is part of this galaxy or not.
Yeah.
It is.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I was asked directly if I knew any spice traders in the Outer Rim, specifically near Ryloth. I don't know.
If we find it, he will be.
I told him, I said, let me get back to you.
You track the spice, you'll find it.
I said, let me get back to you. I'm under fire right now. So that's what I said.
Kind of busy, guys.
Right.
Pew, pew. But no, they were, according to the star charts, they were in this one part of this galaxy, okay? This other galaxy that you never even heard of. And the reason why you know about that is because they had the star charts a part of this ship.
So it was in a galaxy far, far away, but only 2 days ago, so not a long time ago.
Yes, very much. Then it appeared here, and then when it appeared, then it
So was what attacking crashed. Them came with them through that? Portal, or did they get attacked as soon as it came through by somebody that was waiting for them?
I would find this John Doom fellow so we can get information on what was attacking him, so we'll know what we're stepping into, because they might also be wanting said cargo.
But he may be dead.
But he had an escape. See where his escape pod went.
But he said all the escape pods had been jettisoned when he sent out of the Mayday. He went down with the ship. He would have, because he's the captain.
Well, you didn't find a body up there.
I know, but that doesn't mean he's not dead.
Right.
Still need to know what's attacked them.
So I'm going to go scour the information again and see what I can find.
I want to try and repair my armor. Scuff it out again.
While we wait for
you saying?
Young man to wake up.
All right.
3 weeks later.
So you go through the information once again.
Yeah.
You found a manifest. You found a cargo. They were carrying cargo crystals, which they actually have it listed as that too. By the way, that's actually how they have it listed in there. It's cargo crystals, and also spice.
Hey, dude, what are kyber crystals?
What are kyber crystals?
Because I'm not a weapons guy. I wouldn't know, I don't think.
They're what power lightsabers.
Oh, well, there's a whole bunch of them on this ship.
I know. I want some, so I can have lightsabers.
There were a whole bunch of them.
Then let's go get some.
I don't know where they went. They were on the ship. But if the young man was correct, then these bounty hunter raiders have them. But we need to wait for him to wake up so we can see the other half of the ship.
That is true. We are definitely going to need some patience. Let's go. How far away are we from the market?
Let's go beat up that guy again. The one that tried to sell you.
One click.
The one that tried to sell you Mandalorian armor. Let's go rough him up some more.
Nah, we don't need to rough him up again. Poor guy's already traumatized. I made her a point.
From the information of the ship, you did get the crew log, so you do have a picture of the captain.
What does he look like?
He's human.
He's standing there with his feet up in the air, like this. Because everybody's got a little captain in him.
He's human. He has a beard.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Wears an iron mask. green hood.
All right, so let's
go into the market.
Stay here. I'm gonna go to the market and
I'll try and
get some medical supplies to replenish for him.
I'll try and look through this info again just to see if there's anything embedded that might help us.
All right. So Kolu, you head back to the market. Take the speeder bike there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you go back to the market. Now it's about dusk at this point.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you go there and just start scouring the market. So go ahead and make a wisdom.
Zero.
You find your friend again.
Yeah, that's who I was going to go to.
You have the red skin, the one with the piercings in the nose.
Mm-hmm.
He says, look who's come back.
Medical supplies, we need some.
Yes. We all need medical supplies. This is Jakku.
Don't forget to tell him that guy down there sold him for half what he's going to offer to tell you.
Is there anything specific you're looking for?
Yeah, I'm going to purchase some.
I can help you there. See, he shows in. It's the basic medical, but the one he does show you is a med kit that has the Nisalin in it, which you're familiar with this from Felucia.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is stuff that could really, is what the Empire uses to restore their soldiers.
How many of those do you have?
He says, I have 3. Says,
I might take them.
Says, I can sell them to you for 150 credits.
My guy was selling them for 75.
Make a roll.
-2.
He says, 75. But they're not pure like mine are. He's added some ingredients.
I just get frustrated and just throw credits at him. It's like, just take your credits, man.
And then he hands you the med kits.
Oh, wait. Is that 150 for all three or 150 apiece?
150 for all three.
That's not bad.
Yeah, so I just tossed them to him and I got him.
Hit him in the face.
Yeah. Here you go, you peasant.
He says, yes, pleasure doing business. Anything else I can help you with while you're here?
I look at the armor and I just get sad because I know it's not real armor. So I just walk off because there's nothing else I can do. I mean, he's definitely not going to be able to repair my armor because he doesn't know what he's doing.
Oh, you can distress. You can take away.
Okay.
Distress is good. It's a different scene. You too. Verbal. But no, as you walk away, he says, "Ah, what? Nothing else? Do you want a slave, maybe?"
A slave, you say?
Slave, yes. Yes, slave. Slave trade is very popular here.
What slave do you have?
I don't have a slave myself, but I have contacts. I know where you can go to get slave of your own.
Okay. Where would I go?
So he scribbles on a parchment and hands it to you. Says, "Once the sun goes down completely, go to this location."
I get 50 credits and I just put them in his hand. Thank you.
Yes, you are welcome. And don't forget the password. Zygeria.
Zygeria. Okay.
I got you.
I write it down.
Yeah.
And I put it to him. Is that the correct spelling?
Yes.
I don't read much. Thank you.
That is.
All right, sir. Have a good day.
All right. And at this point, the sun's just about down all the way. So, I mean, you could head back, but by the time you do that, then you would just be heading right back over here. So.
No, I'm curious to see who they have. There was just a crash.
Mm-hmm.
My guy's not completely in the dark, so I want to see all these, what they have to offer.
Be careful. I'll tell you when I call them.
Roger that. I think we might find people from the ship there.
Let's see if we can get in touch with your pilot again. Try to reach your pilot. Nope. No response. Comms are still down.
But the storm's pretty much over, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, storm's pretty much over.
Now
at this
we're just
point.
Dealing with the aftermath of the storm.
Right. Gotcha. Now you're in a communication blackout for some reason.
Led Zeppelin told me about that, you know, communication breakdowns and such.
The AC better still be working.
Yeah. That's all I gotta say.
But you burn that motor. Brand new. Alright. So anyways, you follow the address?
Yes.
Okay. It takes you to a hut, actually, this little building that's not too far from where you are, maybe about half a click from the market. All right. Now, as you approach, there's two torches outside giving light, and there's also two bodyguards, and these look like the raiders. Okay, mm-hmm. That's how they're dressed as you pull up.
Okay.
All right. So you approach.
Mm-hmm.
All right. As you approach, they put their hands out and say, "Oh, hold on. What are you doing? Bounty hunter?"
I hit my wrist and show them the password. Just go.
Or a mistake. Please enjoy your time.
Thank you, kind sirs.
All right. So you walk in into the hut. And as you do, you look and you see there's this lift in the center.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you go and you step on the lift, and all of a sudden it just starts taking it down to a lower level. So you reach the lower level, and then as you do, you can hear the noise and everything. There's a party going on.
Party!
Open the comms.
Yo.
You're missing out.
Yeah, I'm working. You always have. You get all the fun.
All right. So you continue forward.
Just continue forward. Grab a drink.
Yep.
partake in the activities, gamble and everything.
You acquire a lot of, you see the servers or Twi'leks. They're serving drinks.
Them Twi'leks, though.
Them Twi'leks.
Why you get all fun, man?
Sitting there just enjoying all the various views, and I'm like, this is what I needed after a stressful day.
And then you hear a voice and says, the auction is beginning. 10 minutes.
All right. So I'm just going to just walk around, not really talk to anybody, because my charisma. Make a wisdom?
Yeah.
I'm just having fun.
You are. You're just zoning like, dude, check this out. Hey, do you see my feed?
I'm going to kick you in the head.
Can he make a wisdom roll because I have my feed on?
No, what you do notice here is that these feline, like the kid, you know, like him, there's quite a few of them, actually. And they're ones that are the ones that are manning the tables. They're the ones that are actually pouring the drinks for the servers.
He said he was the only one.
Well, no, what he said was that there was no family.
Oh, that's right. But I asked him if he was the only one of his kind here. I guess maybe just lost in translation.
No, you can also tell this is a pretty underground thing, too.
Yep. All right. So I noticed that, and I just keep having fun, blending in. And
then you go towards where the auction is taking place?
Yeah.
All right, so the auction begins. And it starts off, all right? And it starts off with, well, a Twi'lek.
Don't buy the Twi'lek.
They start going through the attributes. Great server. Perfect form.
My guy.
Nice shade of blue.
Much intrigue. Much intrigue.
No.
Much intrigue.
They gave us a...
It's like a whisper to the comp.
They gave us unlimited credits.
And in here, starting bid, 100,000 credits.
Never mind.
Well, baby, this is a beautiful ass kid. Too bad we can't stay.
I will just continue to look. We will window shop this.
They can't see the tears in my helmet.
All right. So they, you know, soul. Then it goes to this. Actually, it's a human. Goes to him, and you can tell he's a pretty business person. You know, he has a nice clothes on and everything.
I look at him. He doesn't know. I don't, not that I notice this. Or no, I just look at him and go, just give him a thumbs up.
Alright, and then they go to the next one. They bring him out. And as they do, all of a sudden you hear these sounds. Sounds like a like animal sounds. And you see the two guards that are bringing him out are thrown. And it's a Wookiee.
We want that.
And then before you know it, four of these guards converge on them, and then they have these laser prods, which look very similar to the kids. And then they just start prodding them with lasers.
And nobody's going to want him.
All right. So they've managed to bring him down to his knees, and they shackle him to the ground.
That's starting to agitate me a little bit.
Wait for the opening bid. We'll see what we can do.
And he says, Wookiee. And then he says, this one was captured from the Empire. Their slaver ship malfunctioned. Sole survivor. And for that, we have a starting price of 75,000.
I wait to see if anybody else bids.
All right, and yeah, they're bidding 75, 100, 125. And he's like, he's great for manual labor. You need something built?
How much do we have?
Unlimited.
That's right.
Because we have to get everything. The slave girl, he won't understand. This could help us.
Bid 200.
You just have to explain it.
Yeah, exactly.
Bid 200. Them.
Yeah, I can't explain it.
Hey, bid 200.
Offer 200.
All right. And he says, 200 to the bounty hunter in the back. Can't imagine what you'd use a Wookiee for.
That's none of your business.
Maybe for removing limbs.
Gotta let the Wookiee win, what can I say?
Yep.
I was talking about the trees, but that works too.
I'm a bounty hunter, what do you expect?
Then you hear 250.
300.
Now look, see who's bidding against you, though.
No, I stare him down.
Oh. Yeah, you hear somebody, this is a businessman who went and bought the toilet, by the way. He's the one who bid the 300, or yeah, the 250, excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Go to three.
Then you hear somebody next to you, and then they start, you hear them whispering to each other, and they're like, oh, I really want to bid, but they always save the best for last.
Still go 350.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right.
I'll bid him by 100.
And you see him, he raises it back up. It says 400.
You're not getting two of my dreams. 500.
And he says 600, and you can have this one.
700.
And he goes, 700, do we have an 800? He goes quiet. Going once.
I just stare at him and go.
Going twice. And says, sold to the bounty hunter in the back.
I'm sorry, my love. I whisper to myself.
All right. So they basically keep the Wookiee shackled, and they bring him in shackles to you.
What's the next item up for bids?
Yeah, I was waiting for the next item up for bids. I just want to lean over to the Wookiee that's in shackles and just tell him, do not worry, I'm a friend. You're not going to be in chains with us. I am not your master. We are equals. But please just play the part right now until we get out.
He just kind of looks at you.
Which comes out as.
Exactly.
Yep.
And it's like, I'm like, I can't stand to see anyone held against their will. I'm a bit lustful, yes, but I would have given her choice. But when I see a fighter, a warrior such as yourself shackled like that, no.
And you're like, I don't even know what you're saying.
No, we speak Wookiee.
But he just kind of shakes his head. That's all you can get out of him. He just shakes his head. So you don't know if he is saying, yes, I understand what you're saying, or yes to gravy and the mashed potatoes later.
I ran it through my computers and translated it for him.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
I got a 5.
Good job. Mm-hmm. You're like, here. Play this sound through your
right.
So you do. Mm-hmm. You play it, and then you see actually gets on his knees.
But that makes everybody else go.
Ooh. Yeah, everybody's kind of calming down a little bit more. For last, and then they bring out somebody, and they have a black bag over. one. Rare as rare can be. You may look, but little would you know that he is not from here. And they pull the mask off. Other than John Doom.
Start the bid at 800,000.
You know, just so it kind of like blend in.
Mm-hmm.
And I go, 800,000.
However, you've already won your prize for tonight. Yes, and we appreciate that, but the rules of the auction, one prize per guest. I'll offer 850,000 credits.
Can I send that person a message?
Because you don't even know who they are.
Can you hack? I think he hacked.
You did.
So I'm going to get the guy with the Twilight for you, too.
All right, so... whatever you bid, I'll match it and pay you if you let me have him. I'll double that and send it to you.
Make a roll.
Charisma.
Charisma. Ooh.
Charisma.
That's fine. Somebody roll charisma and send a message.
Roll!
Money talks, man.
Charisma, that's a one.
Over, he starts talking to his droid, and he realizes that the droid's replying with the message. Mm-hmm. And then, but somebody like this is truly invaluable.
May I send a message?
Go ahead and make a roll.
Money talks, man. It's going to be a one.
He says, still, no dice. And here's some credits.
It's like rules are stupid.
Yes, but you do have an option.
Mm-hmm.
You could trade.
Do that. I already told him I wasn't going to do that. Manpower. Could also just find the person that did this and kill him later and take the person. Say, whisper, he bad, kill him, help me kill him. Which he is. They're by.
To my status, I am allowed a second. Bid. This is no. That's too easy. as a high roller. He does. He upgrades your status.
All right.
So you're now a high roller. And the auctioneer, he's like, "What? But sir, we've already." $2 million
happens
to the bounty hunter.
Oh, I lean over to my Wookiee friend, or.
Successfully gets John Doom.
All right.
And what is going on?
Just stop.
And tell him. Stop with the questions.
We'll tell
come
him.
With us.
He says, okay.
As soon as we get to our destination, you'll get them. You'll get all of your answers.
Cool.
We both go. Are we outside now?
Yeah, you guys leave.
We leave? All right.
You got one speeder bike, though. You got three people.
We're going slow.
The Wookiee can run. The Wookiee can run.
I look over to my Wookiee friend. I'm like, we have a lot. We have food and we have medical supplies. Meet us here. I'm like, please meet us here. Trust, we'll get you set up, my friend. We're going to get off this planet. You're getting off of here. You're not going to be a slave. I'm not letting that happen.
So. All right. You do that. And you take John Doom with you.
And also hand him a blaster.
The Wookiee a blaster?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So you take off.
Yeah.
All right. You make it back to camp. All right.
Look what I found. We got a lot of explaining to Gracchus to do. Now I look at John Doom and...
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, I look at John Doom and then I look at the Wookiee. And I tell them, I hope you know I sacrificed my dream for you two. With that being said, John Doom, what questions do you have?
Well, hold on. We got to make sure the boy's okay, use the stim pack on him first.
Yes.
Get him up and going, and we got to get out of here. I just want to find a different place, because if they know where that kid hides or is from, they're going to come to, I don't know, maybe, but...
We killed them all.
Not the ones that we just...
On your device.
What's that?
Turns out that when you did the hack, it was backtraced.
Yep, we gotta go.
We gotta go.
They know it was rigged.
Alright, so we gotta go and get them and get out. Crap. Gotta find another hiding space.
So give him the shot and wake him up and see what, if he's got an idea of where we can hide.
All right. We apply the stim pack to him.
All right, you do. And his condition now begins to improve. Mm-hmm. And he gains consciousness. Mm-hmm. And well, he's still out of it. He's still woozy. And he goes, what? How did I end up back here?
We saved you from the other people that tried to take you. From the Tai Li Yang, or whatever you called it?
Tao Ling, yes.
Well, bad news. Somebody traced us back here. Where can we go?
Yes. I don't know. This is my only home.
It's your only home. Do you not have, like, another hiding spot?
Come on, everybody's got a second bowl hole. Let's go.
He says, maybe the caves.
Well, let's go to a desolate, not inhabited by any weird creature cave. Or let me rephrase that. With nothing in the cave except us.
Also, I leave my main computer there and bring my backup computer with me because that's the one they tracked.
Gotcha.
Yeah. And meanwhile, John Doom said, look, guys, answers.
Look, guys, we're going to die if we don't leave here right now.
We'll give you answers on the way. Please just come with us. Now, what questions do you have as we're getting ready and going?
He's like, where is the rest of my crew? They were here.
No, you tell me what happened to your ship.
We don't know.
Tell you what, maybe.
He goes, no, they were sold before me. I was the last one to be sold. The survivors were taken there and sold.
I didn't get there in time. By the time I got there,
it was the Wookiee.
It was the Twi'lek, the Wookiee, and then you.
He's just pacing around. He goes, he's putting his hands on his head because it's been a long day for him.
Yeah,
long few days. He goes, the ones that were not sold, they were not prime commodity because they were not lieutenants and commanders. They weren't officers. They were just regular people. And they were herded on the ship. And then, of course, you hear the kid. He goes, oh, he looks at John Doom. He says, I'm sorry. They're not coming back. John looks at him and goes, what do you mean they're not coming back? Then the kid explains. They're being taken to Zygeria. They are now property of the Zygerians.
Where's Zygerian? What's a Zygerian?
The kid explains. He says, I am a Zygerian. That is my species. Our homeworld is Zygeria.
Oh, okay.
My mother and father told me of this during the wars. They explained that slavery was very popular. It was what they sold on the planet. But then after the war, everything seemed to have fallen apart.
Mm-hmm.
So that's all I know. But what they've told me is that whoever goes there as a commodity, as slave, they don't return. They remain there. Only the good ones are sold off to other bidders. The others are sent to the homeworld to perform manual labor until they die.
It's terrible.
Of course, John Doom at this point is like, this cannot happen. They are alive. They survived an extinction-level event just to be carried off as slaves? We have to go rescue them.
I get it. I get you want your friends and family and crew back, but we've got bigger problems right now. If we don't get out of here, we're not going to be around to help your friends. So, come on.
I look at him
please
and I'm like,
please just come.
Hey, look, man, we don't have the resources to do that right now. Stay and remain with us, and we might be able to do that. But, like I said, we're your best chance right now. And trust me, I get it. I truly do. But, like my friend here said, we have to get other things done first.
Do we hear people coming yet?
No.
Okay, we gotta
We gotta go. Come with us. I give you my word. I am honor bound. Trust me, I'm honor bound. This hairy fella can vouch for that. We need to get out of here right now. Come with us, please.
All right. You guys hear this outside?
All right. It's like, let's go.
Don't you hear that?
They're coming.
Yep.
All right, they're coming.
And that's Chewy. And then you also... hear the sounds.
Too late, they're here.
You take a quick peek outside, mm-hmm. and you see that the Wookiee is actually tossing people left and right. He's basically, and he looks back, and then he just kind of nods at you. And then he translates as, thank you for saving me. Let me return the favor. And of course, you hear more blaster sounds going on, and you hear mm-hmm. people screaming as they're hitting rocks. So he's bought you some time to get out of there.
We really need him with...
Ask the kid where we're going so we can tell Chewie, yeah. and yeah. then we bolt, and Chewie can meet us there later.
Yeah.
The kid tells you, he goes...
Just tell us so we can tell him.
And then John Doom looks at you guys. Do you have a ship?
Yes, we do. That's what I'm saying. We want him to run to... after we find our cargo that we've been looking for. That's what we were sent here to find. And everybody is after it.
You're talking about the kyber crystals.
Yes, we're talking about the kyber crystals.
I know where they are.
You do? Please, we need to get those.
They're probably where we just came from.
World by now?
Well, then let's get to the ship and the kid.
Well, we need to get to the ship.
Your bounty hunter friends...
They're not our friends, dude. We wouldn't have bought you if they were our friends. We would just
show them where all the cargo was. And then they... says, I'll help you find those. But we need to help my crew as well.
Because trust me, the people that we're dealing with, they don't have too much. Lawyer.
He says, let's get off world first.
Let's get off world. I'm gonna send. Get there. It's like, get through these guys, get there pronto, please. We're taking you off world.
And you guys kind of make a grab the speeder and you take off.
Are we taking boy with us? Is he coming or does he want?
If you leave the boy, they're going to interrogate him.
They're
going to
interrogate him. We're taking him with us because he's compromised. Right. They're just going to kill him. It's like Gracchus will not say he has anything to do with him. He's dead to them at this point.
The Wookiee is being overwhelmed mm-hmm. by the soldiers. Alright, and then you're going around, you look back and you see him.
Mm-hmm.
And then these emotions kind of swell up. Murder somebody. and save him and stop this from happening.
I want to try.
But if you do get involved now, you're going to completely, you know, give away the position because they're all five.
They're just five?
Yeah, right there currently.
Right now?
Yes.
There's just five.
Left.
There's
from
five.
From dealing with the Wookiee.
Well, I mean, if we do that, it would give him a break and then we can make a break.
The ship yet?
No. Still dark.
Still dark.
I'm still trying and no dice.
Okay. Yeah. No.
Ha ha.
And oh my god.
Being with plus one.
Four.
You swing around.
Wait. What's the mm-hmm. aspect?
Oh, that shouldn't be there. That's mm-hmm. from a different scene. Oh.
Complete, like on the other side of Jakku.
Okay.
So they think that we've left. That we're gone. That's what I'm trying to do.
Gotcha. All right. Meanwhile, you fire off the blast, you end up taking out two soldiers. And he puts it right up to the Wookiee's forehead and pulls the trigger. So you have a choice, you can engage, but his traces will. At this point, the intelligence officer that you are, that
this quick, we need to get through this.
Kill the guy that's trying to shoot the wood.
So, yes, you take him out. You take out the guy, the leader.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Lee's. And your speeders are overloaded as it is.
Jesus Christ, no.
All right. So you give the Wookiee a stim pack.
We're hauling. Come with us, but the Wookiee's injured. He needs to be on the bike right now.
Yep.
The Wookiee.
You and the Wookiee, all right. You and the Wookiee are on the bike. And everybody else is just walking, right?
Running, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. All right. Cool. And that's where we're going to end for tonight. Join us next time with Saturday Night Gaming to continue the adventures of the Liberator as they liberated a Wookiee tonight.
Yeah.
And make sure you like, share, subscribe.
Yeah, with like, everybody. Share, subscribe.
Everybody.
Yes.
We love you.
Yes, we do.
That we do.
Join us next time.